To Christy Jarabai here, Elem Domizulu. This is a chives plant. This chives, I planted it almost a year ago, and now it's flowering, showing flowers. Again, you see the flowers. So my question is, I wanted to eat these flowers or somehow use them, because I believe that there's more to these chives than that. So I'm still going to ask a few questions. If anyone else has thought about it and considered that, because it's almost a year, it's chives. Now, on here, this is also strawberries. We planted them almost a year ago. My little girl planted this almost a year ago, and she has been picking a number of strawberries, ripened strawberries, once in a while. And it's fantastic, it's great, and we like that strawberry. And this is one more, we call it mbora, in Zimbabwe, mbora. Right, that's
in your peanut, steaming peanut butter. That's pumpkin. You boil the pumpkin, and then you, when it is boiled enough, you put 1 teaspoon of peanut butter. You stir together in the pot on the boiling, leave them for a while, and then you can have it. A nice scalding in your pea. That's good food.
My steaming hot is very hot. Just from the pumpkin, no salt, no sugar, water. This is the water that we use, purest water.
Right, purest water, zero. You see, 100% free of all fluoride, chlorine, sodium, and additives. It's brilliant tasting. All right? And these are the seeds. These are the seeds from the pumpkin, which we will dry and then grind and drink as tea. That's what we use, that's what we have. So then after this breakfast, having had this breakfast, we're going to enjoy some mango, right? Fresh mango, just to run dry. And this is our own baked bread, right? Fantastic own baked bread. A little bit of tahini, unhealed tahini in the chocolate. And to sweeten everything, we don't use sugar to sweeten everything. We use date syrup. Squeeze date syrup in it a little bit. And then bake just like normal bread. That's vegan bread. This just brief show of the healthy foods that we're trying to implement and trying to eat. But at the end of the day, we have to use wooden stuff, wooden plates. Like that, yes, fantastic. Everything goes all like that. A mango here, good mango. Health, this is the season for mangoes. That's what we should have for breakfast. So pumpkin, it's not pumpkin soup. This is called inopi. Slice of unbaked bread and a mixture of dried grounded pumpkin seeds, and then that's it, that's breakfast. Be harvesting and eating the leaves. This is my field, this is my maize, and this brand of maize is Mexican. It's one of those rare breeds, Mexican. I know it's Mexican. And oh, is that, and this is again mbora. I see that. I hope you can see that mbora. Or pumpkin leaves. We eat pumpkin leaves. We use them, right? Fantastic. These are cherries, tomatoes, and quite fantastic here. That's one thing there. And I know many of you. You know that's sugar cane. That's sugar cane. And this is that Mexican corn. Mexican corn. I know Dr. Sebi had a lot of contribution in my understanding of corn. This is corn. And my problem with this one is already it's starting to have pollen, But the little one has not yet come up. I don't know how it does that, but this is my second year planting this this one breed. I think it's a hybrid, but maybe a better one. There's more of my corn there. There's more of my corn. And there is the other dumbe, right? Yamu. And we come here again. There is more what I want to show to share here. This is this is aloe vera. I let it grow and it grew up and now it's coming up again. This aloe vera, I normally use it just to as on my inkenke on my legs to, when my legs get become dry, because I normally walk barefoot most of the time. So this preacher rabbi, and this is my vegetable that I eat a lot, and more. This is my kale, right? Or kale, maybe. So kale, right? This is my kale, and these yellow leaves. It shows that they don't have a lot of nitrogen. That's what from a scientist. But I normally love to eat these yellow leaves myself. See these holes in there? These holes, because these holes, insects attack these. Insects love it. They know that this is natural. So insects come and eat this. I once planted it with another hybrid, and it was never touched. But they attacked the and ate the leaves on the one that is not a hybrid. So tell me what you think about my chives there, and when it's flowering, I'll do a number of from there. Thank you so much. This is preacher Rabbi Ellen Tumizulu. This is my little garden. It reminds me of the way I grew up, a village boy in the gardens, in the fields, herding cattle, goats, and sheep, plowing fields and doing all the chores. I still envy that life, innocent life, no hassles, no hassles at all. Thank you. Goodbye. Have a good day.